Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, stand for truth or fall for anything. Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go therein. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way that leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravenous wolves. Matthew 7:13-15. In the 70s in America, there was a popular saying, if it feels good, do it. Today we hear that same mentality expressed in sentiments like, what truth is for you may not be what it is for me. The saying has so thoroughly saturated our culture that our top value as a nation is tolerance. Tolerance today does not merely mean that you accept another person for who they are. No, indeed. Today, the term tolerance means that you must affirm, endorse people's values and behaviors as well. If not, then you're a bigot or some other malicious creature. If Jesus were to be judged by today's standard, he would be one of the most intolerant, politically incorrect, fundamentalist extremists who ever walked the face of this earth. He was dogmatic and subscribed to the idea that there are absolute standards of right and wrong. Jesus rejected relativism. In Matthew 7:13-14, he stated, one can enter God's kingdom only through the narrow gate. The highway to hell is broad and its gate is wide for many who choose that way. But the gate to life is small and the road is narrow and only a few ever find it. Many resent the fact that the New Testament has only one plan of salvation, which can be found in Acts 2:38. They want a multi-plan salvation. In other words, all belief systems are not equally valid. As far as Jesus was concerned, there was only one way to find life, his way. Every other path, every other religion or philosophy or belief leads to destruction. Few find the way to real life. Buying into the idea of no absolute opened up a Pandora's box of stupidity on our lives. Without moral anchors, we drift over the waterfalls of sanity. The enemy becomes people who hold strong values and convictions. We, the church. Strong faith is now fanaticism. What used to be viewed as virtue are now condemned as vices. Once there is no absolutes, then our feelings become our guide and our God. Feelings are great followers, but poor leaders. If we are led by our feelings, we will never do anything that is painful or requires sacrifice. Feelings become more than your guide. They eventually become our God. Rather than upholding God's standard, which are clearly spelled out in the Bible, we opt for going on intuition and feeling. Child of God, today, if we desire to make it in, we have to internalize God's absolute truth to do what is right, even when what is right is not popular. The thought of the day, if we are led by our feelings, we will never do anything that is painful or requires sacrifice. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.